Hi everybody, it's me. It's Dr. Kestler from Lorain County Community College with today's co-video. I want to point out a couple of things today. First of all, I will not be doing a co-video this weekend. My temperature today is 96.7 degrees Fahrenheit or 35.9 degrees centigrade. And I want to also point out to you that, and I think this is something that you already know, cases are flat in the United States. Deaths are flat in the United States. We have the number of cases are pretty flat. We are not at this time declining yet. And even in Ohio, we seem to be going through a couple of spurts where we're actually going up. The rate is going up a little bit. So we, even though things are opening up almost everywhere in the United States, we need to be ever vigilant. And we need to be wearing masks because masks are the only way. Especially this is important because of something I'm about to share in a second here. But first I want to give you an update on a vaccine. This is another new vaccine. I'm hoping that we have a vaccine by September, maybe January. But I certainly, certainly a vaccine ends this whole story. This is a killed virus vaccine, which is sort of like the sock vaccine that we use for polio. And we're currently using that vaccine right now for polio. And what they showed, they used this, they made the vaccine. This is a Chinese company that made it. They were able to inoculate monkeys, rhesus monkeys, and then they challenged the monkeys with pathogenic COVID-19, and the monkeys were protected. Small number of animals, obviously a lot of work to go on that. There are many people doing the same sort of things, and the vaccine world is working hard, and I'm really very much encouraged by that. Something I learned that was new today is we've been talking about asymptomatic people and walking around, and we actually have some data on that. And this came out of China, and they looked at people who were symptomatic and asymptomatic, and they determined that on average about 86% of the people who were infected with COVID, 86% were undocumented, were asymptomatic, did not know that they were positive. And that's that means there's probably quite a bit few more cases in the United States than there are, which is, and it also means that those of you who are healthy wearing a mask, for those of you who are healthy, is a good thing to do for others who are not exposed at this time. Because you might, that is how they believe that most of the virus disseminated throughout China, not the sick people. The sick people didn't spread the virus. The people who were healthy spread the virus. So that is something to consider as we move forward. The other paper that was fairly interesting was the shelter-in-place rules. The shelter-in-place rules work. Mobility, movement of people, moving them, not allowing them to move and do a lot of traveling was a very effective part of how China got through its story. And I want to just show you some data here. And this is some data. If you look at this, this is the this is a measurement of travel. They're studying how people travel, and they're showing you a timeline from 2 years, this year and the year before. And they've kind of lined them up so that the Lunar New Year is right nearby there. And what you can see is that in the middle and on the bottom, you can see that when they put in restrictions for shelter in place, they were able to control the infection. And on the bottom graph, we're looking at R0 values. That's the number of people that infect other people. So when it goes down to zero, when it goes down to zero, that means that people are not being infected, it's not spreading. And in the center, there's a little graphic showing you a heat map, a color heat map of the amount of people traveling in the beginning, and then after the shelter in place happens, what happens to the travel then. For those of you who don't know what cordon sanitaire is, that is basically preventing people from traveling. That's a shelter in place rule. And what this little graphic shows you is what happened after they instituted it. And what happened after they instituted it is you saw that there was a definite control of spread even where there was a lot of virus around. And so you can see the Wuhan province there in green up at the top, and the height of the green on the x-axis shows you that how much is, or the y-axis is showing you how much of the extent of the infection is, how much spread there has been. And even though there was travel to other places, you can see that there's very little spread. This here shows you, the next graph shows you that after they introduce the shelter in place rule, what happens to the numbers. And the numbers of people infected actually goes down really fast. And on the right hand side of this slide, you can see that there is, the rates are going down. There is a rate of being spread early. You can see it goes up from I think the beginning of January through the middle of January, but afterwards the rate actually declines. And so that just shows you that these kinds of efforts truly do work and are beneficial. All right, before I finish here, I just want to say that there is, you know, there's a lot of stress. There's a lot of people who are having issues with being in place and being depressed, and that there is help around. I want to remind you, be good to each other, and may you persist like a lentivirus.